We introduce the arthroscopic capsular application for multidirectional shoulder instability in hypermobile Ehlers Danlos syndrome patients. Consider poorly described multidirectional shoulder instability does not yet have a precise definition. However, it is common to observe in the Ehlers Danlos syndrome patient, as in the multidirectional instability patients, a patellous and loose joint capsule, as well as a labral complex that seems ineffective and incongruent during the first exploratory phase of the arthroscopic procedure. During the exploration, if an eventual labral lesion has to be found, it must be repaired using a classical anchor technique. The procedure is initiated using a clever hook, which is passed at the 5 o'clock position into the capsular tissue in length of approximately 1 to 2 centimeters. Once a satisfactory amount of tissue have been crocheted by the clever hook, it is possible to use a shorter relay wire guide that has to be put inside the articular joint. Once positioned in the articular joint, the wire guide can be retrieved using an accessory portal. This accessory portal is recommended to be performed right next to the anterior instrumental portal. Using the passing suture technique, a non-absorbable high-strength suture treats can then be passed through the inferior capsular tissue. A specific caution must be made not to over-tie the knot so as not to risk tearing the capsular tissue. We recommend to tie all the capsular application performed with the upper limb maintained at 30 degrees of abduction and forward flexion and with a neutral rotation to prevent any excessive postoperative loss of motion. The entire aspect of the capsule is then first plicated. This is with the goal not to close too much the entire aspect of the capsular joint when the posterior plication is started first. As for the metallic wire guide, a polydioxanone suture treats can also be used as a shorter relay to pass the suture treats. And due to the deficiency of the labrum for this patient, we do not believe that there is a need to involve the labrum into the repair. For this patient, our recommendation is to perform two anterior capsule applications associated with the inferior capsule application. The second and last anterior application is initiated just above the last one at the 3 o'clock position following the same surgical procedure. The two goals of this procedure are to reduce the capsular volume and thereby allow improved proprioception to aid patients' rehabilitation after this surgery. At this stage, and more specifically for patients without a clear multidirectional shoulder instability, a persistent drive-through can be assessed intraoperatively, making eventually reconsider the indication for posterior capsular application. We do not recommend to perform an interval rotator crochure, not to reduce abusively the postoperative range of motion. Passing the arthroscope through the anterior portal, it is then possible to introduce a cannula through the posterior capsular tissue. The first posterior capsular application is initiated right next to the posterior portals at the 7 o'clock position. The posterior capsular tissue includes between the point path through the use of the clever hook and the posterior instrumental portal with the cannula must be included in the posterior capsular application. The last posterior application can then be initiated at the 9 o'clock position following the same procedure. The main objective of this procedure is to reduce the range of motion at the level of the glenohumeral joint in order to reduce and relieve the patient's pain. Also, we do believe that the restoration of a satisfied labral height is useless in order to recreate a concavity and compression effect for this patient. The use of glenoid anchor just seems absurd to us as it just may lead to an alteration of the cartilage of the glenoid rim. We can see the final aspect both posteriorly and anteriorly of the capsular application. We thank you for watching.